manufacturing tricks, difference is squares. You may recall that when we had two binomials multiplied times each other and they were identical except for the signs, then we got a squared minus b squared, which is a difference of squares. The difference of squares is always going to be in this form. And the way that we recognize it is that we're looking for something that's squared. If you don't already have them memorized, I would recommend that you know all your square numbers up to 16 squared. That should mean that you only have to memorize these four, because you should already know 1 through 12, the perfect squares that are in there, because you should know your multiplication facts. If you don't, you've got to get these perfect squares memorized, because you're going to be using them a lot. So let's take a look at our examples. The only way that we can factor difference of squares is if we know the formula, which is that we're going to have two sets of parentheses. We're going to take the square root of the first term, the square root of the second term. We're going to have plus in one, minus in the other. If you don't know that formula, there's just no way of factoring a difference of squares. So, important to memorize the formulas. So let's take a look at example one. We have a perfect square there for our first term. We have a perfect square for our second term. That means that we have a difference of squares. Take and write down your two sets of parentheses. Write down the square root of the first term, the square root of the second term, which is 9. Put plus in one, minus in the other, and it does not matter the order. You could have just as easily have written a minus 9, a plus 9. But you want to make sure that you have opposite signs. Let's take a look at example two. I have a perfect square for the first term. I have a perfect square for the second term. So, I'm going to put in my two sets of parentheses. The square root for my first term is 7x. The square root for my second term is 5y. Plus in one, minus in the other. Again, order doesn't matter. And you've got these factored. Commit the formula to memory.